Post Malone is one of the most popular musicians out there right now, and his unique music style has helped him reach the top quickly. Since his music is influenced by more than one genre, it offers something for almost everyone. Not only is Post's music style unique, so is where he likes to live. Although he has spent a fair amount of time living in Los Angeles like most celebrities, his current multi-million dollar house is actually in Utah. Not to mention he's prepped his home for an apocalypse. In this video, we'll be giving you all the details of his mansion and more. Austin Richard Post, known to the world as Post Malone, is a rapper, singer, songwriter, and record producer, and he's only 24 years old at the moment. Although his debut single, White Iverson, just came out in 2015, he found fame pretty quickly. Post is known for his songwriting, vocal style, and because he seems to blend different genres in his music, like hip-hop, pop, rock, and even country. I can say there are many artists who are able to do that successfully. I'm sure part of why Post likes to experiment with multiple genres is because he himself loves variety. In fact, he admits to always having loved emo music, something him and I totally have in common. Not to mention his first step into professional music was actually being in a heavy metal band. Considering most of Post Malone's albums and songs have been featured on the Billboard charts and he's already sold over 65 million records in the US, he's made a fortune. His estimated net worth is already at 14 million or more. Hey guys, it's Kara, and today we're doing another house tour here on Famous Entertainment. A few of you guys have actually been requesting a house tour for Post Malone, so that's exactly what we're gonna do. We'll look at his current mansion in Utah, what's so different about it, and much more. If you like these videos, make sure you're subscribed and ring that bell to be notified when we post so you can always be up to date. We've also done house tours in the likes of Ozzy Osbourne and Vanessa Bryant, and we'll have links to some at the end of this. Follow me on Instagram because I love connecting with you guys. I've also been reading all your comments and I'm gonna be responding to some at the end of this. I need you to let me know who to do next in the comments down below and whose home you'd like to see. Now let's get into this video. I'm not sure if Post Malone has a house in Los Angeles currently, but we do know that he used to. One house, or mansion rather, that he called home went up on the market for a period of time. Sources report that Post was living here quite recently, even into 2019. He was renting this home for an undisclosed amount, but when it was listed for sale, it had a price tag of $26 million. Post Malone's previous mansion was in none other than the neighborhood of Beverly Hills, and was perched high above the street, giving him a ton of privacy. The home was 11,200 square feet of living space and had 6 beds, 7 full baths, and 2 half baths. Mark Whipple designed this place and it was modern as can be. The color scheme included a lot of monochromes and dark painted woods. Just looking at this house, you could guess that a celebrity lives there. There are plenty of open spaces and the common living space included 2 living rooms and a formal dining area. A large kitchen was attached to the dining room and it had futuristic light fixtures which matched the vibe of the home perfectly. Of course, any modern house in the hills needs to have entire glass walls, which gave Post views of the city and the coastline. Some features of Post's modern mansion include plenty of indoor / outdoor spaces, high-tech add-ons, a home movie theater, a gym, a wine cellar, and more. Moving upstairs, you'll find the master suite takes over the top floor, considering it has its own lounge, walk-in closet, private deck with spa, and a master bathroom complete with double vanities, giant tub, and glass shower. There's also a super sleek fireplace right across from the master bed and below the TV. I'm sure all of that was enough for Post to feel like a rock star, but another big selling point about this mansion was the yard. Outside of the mansion, there's a one-of-a-kind wraparound infinity pool which was clearly built to impress. Elsewhere on the property, there's a sunken fire pit, outdoor kitchen, zen garden, and even a putting green. Of course, there was also a guest house for when Post had visitors staying over. Prior to this place, Post used to live in Encino, California from December 2017 to July 2018, according to records. He shelled out $12,000 each month to call this place his. Encino is in the San Fernando Valley area of Los Angeles, and although it is in Beverly Hills, plenty of celebs call this neighborhood home, including Logan Paul. Anyways, Post Malone's Encino rental mansion was over 4,000 square feet of living space and had 5 beds, 4.5 baths, and is estimated at $2.5 million. It may not be as fancy as the Beverly Hills house I just showed you, but it was still super nice. The home was originally built in 1960 and had gorgeous glass double door entrance and sat on about half an acre of land. Of course, there were the signature high ceilings, a massive gourmet kitchen, and an open floor plan. Some other features of his Encino home were the large swimming pool and spa out back, and the barbecue and patio area. Although we haven't seen much about this house, it got a little bit of attention in 2018 when it was robbed on Labor Day weekend, since the burglars thought Post still lived there. They broke into the home, pistol whipped the current owner, and stole $20,000 worth of cash and other personal items. So, like I mentioned, Post Malone decided to invest in some real estate somewhere different than your average celeb, Utah. Honestly, I think Utah's one of my favorite states, so I don't blame him. It's full of beautiful landscapes, and the hikes and mountains are something else. If you didn't know, Post has always been suspicious of the government, which is why he's a card-carrying member of the NRA and has an extensive gun collection, some of which include a Desert Eagle, two gold-plated Glocks, and more.
Oh, yeah!
He keeps these guns handy at his Utah compound, but it's not the only crazy thing about his house. Post Malone actually bought this place for a reason and explained. "I'm just buying a place out in the sticks. I'm building it underground. It's going to be fun until the world ends, but whenever the world ends, it's going to be functional. I'm gonna put in like 30 bunk beds. It's free country out there. Like, you can buy suppressors in Utah. You can do open carry. Walk into the grocery store with a handgun on your hip. Cowboy sh**, I can't wait." Well, clearly the man has a plan and he isn't all talk. He's in the works of building those 30 bunk beds for his crew, or already has, as well as a home recording studio. Post bought this place for around $3 million last year, and it's located in northern Utah, right in the peaceful mountains, away from the action, but still close enough to Salt Lake City. The property sprawls across 6.75 acres of land and has breathtaking views of the canyons, mountains, and the city skyline. The mansion itself spans over 12,000 square feet of living space and has 5 beds and 6 baths. Looking at the photos, you can see how almost every room offers floor-to-ceiling windows to make the most out of the views, even the master bedroom. Post has all the features one could ask for in his Utah mansion, including a chef's kitchen, bar, multiple living spaces, and a private office. If that's not enough, he also has a wine cellar, home gym, and staff quarters. Moving outside of Post's house, the massive estate has a full outdoor kitchen, pool and spa, expansive deck with room for more than a dozen people, and even a basketball court. Like I mentioned, Post Malone is building an underground bunker on his property, and according to rumors, it's already done. Unfortunately, we have no photos of that though. Maybe he's trying to keep it private so nobody tries to visit when the world is ending. Post has also said about his Utah oasis, "Being in Utah and being away from the grind and from everybody else, and it's just me with my video games and a cold one, that feels good to me." It sounds to me like he's more than happy living in his Utah mansion. Just because we know he has a pretty impressive one, let's talk about something else Post Malone has at his property, his car collection. I'm sure with all his land, he has more than enough room to park all of his babies, including his new multi-million dollar Bugatti. One of his first priorities when he made it was to purchase his dream cars. We know Post has a custom Lincoln Continental, a Chevrolet C10 pickup, a purpose-built 5150 Raptor Baja Racer, a Subaru, an old SUV that he remodeled into the Postmobile, or the Texas Whip as he likes to call it, and also owns more than one Rolls Royce, including a Phantom. But the craziest car purchase Post has made is definitely his recent Bugatti Chiron. He just got the car in 2019 and it's all white and, according to him, unlike anything he's driven and super fast. I mean, he spent $3 million on this thing, so you'd have to assume it really is that impressive. I don't know who else spends this much on their wheels aside from Kylie Jenner, who also has one of these Bugattis. So now we've seen Post Malone's mansion in Utah that also doubles as his hideout for the apocalypse. His compound has some of the nicest surroundings and views that I've ever seen, and I think it's pretty cool he'd rather live away from the craziness that is Hollywood. We also took a look at the mansions he used to rent while he was living in LA, like the one in Encino and Beverly Hills, and his crazy car collection. Like I said earlier, I'm not sure if Post still has a home base in California, but if you guys know, be sure to tell me in the comments. What was your favorite part of Post Malone's Utah compound? Aside from all the outdoor space, I also love the floor-to-ceiling windows inside. Okay guys, now I'll read out some comments from our previous vids. On our Ozzy Osbourne house tour, United Snakes of America said, "Ozzy is still my hero, lol, I would not have moved from the goth house myself, that place was effing beautiful." Honestly, I like that house the best too. It had the most personality and I would have loved to have some goth in my house. On our Vanessa Bryant house tour, Ron Channels asked, "How do you find all this information and do you get to meet the celebrities?" Honestly, Ron, it's just top secret research, but not really. I just try my best to get it right, and I wish I got to meet them, but I don't think they know who I am yet. Maybe one day. And finally, on our Dwayne The Rock Johnson house tour, Morticia Styles sent a few comments and said, "The Georgia crib is for me, and also mentioned that she liked my voice and wishes it was the one on her GPS. I'm truly flattered with that last comment, girl, thank you. And I liked his Georgia crib the best too." Alright guys, that's all I could find on Post Malone's estate in northern Utah. What did you think of his mansion? Do you think it's a good place for the end of the world bunker? I think the spots he rented in LA were nice, but I definitely prefer his current home. He picked the perfect spot and the scenery looks like paradise. Let me know in the comments as well as what other celebrity houses you'd like to see. Follow me on Instagram if you want to chat, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye.